Welcome back to my channel. Today it's time to look at another god of Irish mythology. Let's talk about Ogma, or Ogmios. The Irish god Ogma is a member of the Tuatha Danann, but it's a little bit complicated to determine how he fits into the Tuatha Danann, or in other words, who his family is. In the Lefa Gabala Éireann, the book of the taking of Ireland, he is said to be the brother of the Dagda, and the son of Ilaha or Itain, and Eliu or Aene. However, like always in Irish mythology, there are contradicting stories, sometimes describing him to be the son of Brigid, or even the son of the Dagda and Danu. He is said to be the father of Dedaba and Tirin. It's not quite sure who the mothers are, but at least for Tirin, it's assumed that it's maybe one of Ogma's own possible mothers, Aene. As you can see, the topic of his family is a little bit confusing, and so contradicted by various stories, that I think it's best not to further think about it. But from all the various legends of the Tuatha Danann I heard so far, I would say it's safe to say that Ogma, Dagda and Lu are often said to be brothers, but in the bigger picture, maybe more in the sense of brothers in arms, or something like that, and not really brothers in the sense of having the same parents. However, he's also known as Grianach, sunny countenance, or Trina, strong man. He is said to have been the fairest of the so-called sons of Danu, and he was gifted with poetic prowess and the skill of writing. In fact, he was so gifted and creative that he is said to have invented the Ogham writing system, just by studying the flight of cranes. He is also said to have invented various languages, and to be a gifted poet. So gifted, in fact, that bards and poets prayed to get a glimpse of his Awen, his poetic inspiration. Thanks to all those talents, he's the god of language, poetry, speech, writing, invention, inspiration, music, learning, and strength, and the patron of the bards and poets. But despite seeming to be a poet only gifted in the ways of the mind, he's also a very strong man and a great warrior. In fact, he was the chief warrior of the Tuatha Danann, and it was him who tested Lu on his strength when he first came to Tara. In the mythological cycle, he threw a big boulder through a wall, a boulder so big even a team of oxes wouldn't have been able to move it. But Lu picked the boulder up and threw it back as if it was just a small pebble, and at the same time even fixed the wall. Later, Ogma fought in the Battle of Moytura, killed the Fomorian king Indek, but died there and then of the wounds inflicted by Indek. But the magical club of the Dagda was able to revive brave Ogma, and for his braveness, he was awarded Orna, the magical sword of the former Fomorian king Terra, the sword that always sung of the glorious deeds of its bearer. Since he has a similar name and similar attributes, the Irish god Ogma is often equated to the Celtic god Ogmios. Ogmios is a god best known in Gaul. He is the god of eloquence, and often depicted as a bald man wearing a lion skin and wielding a club and a bow. The ancient Romans thought him to be the Gallic version of Hercules or Heracles, and sometimes of Hermes or Mercury. Sometimes Ogmios is depicted with a group of men who are bound to him through a chain leading from their ears to his tongue. Obviously, this is a reference to his eloquence, that people are tied to his lips. Just in this depiction, it's a little bit more literally. He is said to be a psychopomp, a god who leads the dead into the afterlife, and he is said to be a binding god, able to bind people to himself and to control their actions, depicted by the man chained to him, who seemed to be smiling and following him willingly. So it's debatable if Ogmios and Ogma are two versions of the same god, but they both are skilled in words and language, and they both have supernatural strength. So, in all their differences, it's understandable to think of them as two versions of the same entity. The god of eloquence language, and inspiration. And that's it about Ogma and Ogmios. Thank you for listening. If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to be notified when new videos come out. And if you want to know more about Celtic mythology, take a look at my other videos. And if you happen to be Irish and caught me mispronouncing something, please let me know in the comments how to pronounce it properly. Gormel Margot. See you next time. Bye!